friends, and welcome back to Swift Lessons for another lead guitar tutorial. In today's session, I'm going to be sharing with you some of my favorite Memphis soul style licks over a grooving 1-2-4-5 progression in the key of C major. Now we're going to get started learning how to play that progression, some of those chord shapes that are inspiring the licks that I'm playing, and also some of the scale positions that I'm visualizing before adding these smooth melodic phrases into your repertoire. Now I've got a full PDF study guide for you at patreon.com/swiftlessons. You can become a member there and gain access to a ton of extra resources for all my popular YouTube guitar lessons. Now let's get started breaking down everything you heard in the demonstration. Okay, close look at the fretboard, getting started with section one of this lesson. Learning that 1-2-4-5 progression in the key of C major. It's a very popular progression for soul, Motown, R&B, whatever you want to call it. Now, before we jump in, I want to give you an equipment rundown for those of you who enjoyed the tone in the demonstration. I'm using my main guitar. It's a 1993 Gibson Les Paul Studio. It's going into a Fender Supersonic amp, and I'm using two pedals that I think are tremendous additions for anyone's pedal board, and that is the Boss RV6. That's a reverb pedal, and also the Boss Digital Delay. I like Boss pedals because they're very tough, very durable. They last you years and years. Getting started with the one chord in the key of C, C major. All right, shown here, barred off of the third fret, rooted on the A string. We have third fret A, and then with your ring finger, you're gonna bar across the D, G, and the B string. If you're also barring with the index finger, that's gonna give you a very clear tone, C major. Now, the next note in the key of C is D, which is turned into a minor chord shape. Okay, so you have that minor shape here. It looks like an A minor chord, right? Bar in the fifth fret, we have 7, 7, 6 on the D, G, and B strings. So that's a 1-2 progression. All right, now if we take the pinky, put it up on the eighth fret of the A string, we have the F major 4 chord, okay? Great way to play this chord shape, especially if you're playing R&B. Now bring that up a whole step for the 5 chord, G. So there you have it. You have a 1, a 2, a 4, and a 5. Okay, so now that you have those chord shapes, let's put them to work. Let's add a little bit of a groove and also a structure. So we could have two measures of the C major chord like this. Okay, just arpeggiating down, A, D, G strum on the high strings there, nice and short, letting that reverb give it a little bit of an echo feel. A little slap back. We can have two measures on the D minor chord, 1 and a 2, and 3 and a 4, and 1 and a 2, and 3 and a 4. We could do the same thing on the F chord, but cut it in half, a 1 and a 2, and 3 and a 4, 1 and a 2, and 3 and a 4. Same thing on the G chord, and then go back to the 1 chord, 1 and a 2, and a 3 and a 4, and a 1 and a 2, and a 3 and a 4, and a. Very commonly adding in the dominant 7 at the end of the progression just to kind of drive it back to the beginning. Okay, so that's a very common way of navigating through that 1-2-4-5 progression. Okay, tremendous work, everybody. You've added a classic chord progression to your repertoire. And for those of you who are trying to become better lead guitar players, remember, the fastest way to do that is to become a better rhythm player. Now, that might seem counterintuitive, but as a lead guitar player, many of the best ideas you're gonna have are going to be drawn right out of the chord progression. It's gonna tell you which notes work best, and it's gonna also reveal many of the positions that you can play in. All right, now let's jump into section two of this lesson, learning the major pentatonic scale in the G and E positions. These are the scale positions that I'm visualizing as I'm jamming along with that backing track. Okay, taking a look at the G position of the C major pentatonic scale. So if I play a C chord as a G shape, just taking my G chord, transposing it up to the eighth fret, and barring, I'll find that there's a position of the C major pentatonic scale built right in. Okay, so we have the 8th fret of the low E string, then 5-7 on the A, 5-7 on the D, 5-7 on the G, 5-8 on the B, and 5-8 on the high E string as well. So many fantastic possibilities inside that position, which will serve you as a safety net. Whenever in doubt, run back into that position. There's plenty of safe licks for you to play there. Okay, now another position of the major pentatonic scale that I use very commonly would be the E position. So just playing a C bar chord rooted off of the low E string. This position looks and sounds like this. Okay, so just five notes of the major scale in C. So we have 8 to 10, 7 to 10, 7 to 10, 7 to 9, 8 to 10, 8 to 10. All right, practice that nice and slow. Get lots and lots of quality repetitions learning those two scale positions. It'll help quite a bit. Okay, very good, everybody. Thus far, we have mastered that 1, 2, 4, 5, progression in the key of C, and also two positions of the major pentatonic scale, that G position, and also that E position. Now, let's learn some of my favorite Memphis soul style licks. Okay, demonstrating my first lick over C major. It's actually gonna come in just before the progression starts on beat number 4. A 1, and 2, and 3, and a... Alright, very cool kind of B.B. King inspired blues phrase here. Alright, so we're on the 5th fret of the D string, and we're playing 5 to 7. 5th fret of the G string short, and then that same exact note, long, just as the C chord comes in. That's a great way to start a solo in this genre. Okay, then we're into the C chord now. On beat number 2, we have the option of hitting some dead strings. Because once we've gotten there, we're gonna play 6-8 on the B string. And then we're going to bend that 7th fret of the G string with that middle finger. It's actually a back bend, so you bend first, pick, and then descend. Okay, so far you have. All right, that'll get you back to the 5th fret of the G string, that C note. Give that a nice sweet vibrato. Okay, I'm using that B.B. King style butterfly or dove's wing vibrato. All right, nice and even with the rhythm. Okay, now my next phrase is going to have a bit of a Hendrix influence to it. It's gonna sound like this. Real slow now. Okay, dropping myself back off on C once again. So, barring the D and the G string, 5th fret, I'm gonna do a hammer up to the 7th fret of the D string. Return back, and then we're gonna slide. A string, 7th fret down to 5. And then resolve on the 3rd fret of the A string. Okay, putting licks 1 and 2 together, it would sound like this. 1, 2, 3, and 4, and a 1. Okay, then we'll have another optional dead stroke on the 2nd beat of measure number 2 of the progression. Okay, next we have a very cool ascending lick that's going to transition from C major to D minor. It's gonna sound like this. A 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1 and 2. Ah, and then right here, I dropped myself off onto two notes that are inside of that D minor chord shape. So that's kind of the thought process behind that ending part of the lick. So real slow now, that phrase one more time, starting from the end of lick number 2. Here it is. Okay, so we had the third fret of the A string, that slap on beat number two. Then we're on the low E string, 3-5. A string, 5 slide into 7. 5-7 on the D. Emphasis on the fifth fret of the G string. All right, then we're gonna slide from 7 up to 9. Eighth fret of the B string. And then double stop. Taking that position down a whole step, I have the seventh fret of the G, sixth fret of the B string. Okay, you put all that together and it sounds like this super slow so you can get it. Okay, now from the beginning of that measure. Okay, now playing licks 1, 2, and 3 together, going from C major to D minor. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, so we just got dropped off on D minor. Now we're going to use some slide-in double-stop phrases that are kind of spaced apart for a little bit more of a laid-back feel. So playing through this measure sounds like this, starting from where we'd left off. Getting a little country there. Okay, so we had that 7th fret of the G string, 6th fret of the B string, that's 1. A dead stroke on 2, then right after that, I'm gonna play. Sliding from 3 up to 5 on the D, 5 on the B, and then back down to the 3rd fret, double pluck. All right, that brings you to beat number 4 for a nice dead stroke. Then we're gonna play a little country phrase there. 4th fret B, 3rd fret high E. Take it up 3 frets, and then slide away, okay? All right, so that measure over D minor, one more time, starting from beat number 1, 1, 2, and 4. Okay, now playing everything that we have so far. 1, 2, 3, and. Okay, next we have a transition lick taking you from the minor 2 chord to the 4 chord, so D minor to F major. It's gonna sound like this, coming in right after the second beat. One more time. And nice and slow. Okay, and that's a very important note for me to have inside of that F chord. I really wanted to make sure that I hit it right on the one beat of F major because that note is actually inside of the F major chord, okay? All right, let's break that down. Okay, so this lick begins on the 5th fret of the D string going up to 7. 5th fret of the G string, back to 7 on the D, back to 5 on the G, and then we're gonna slide from 7 up to 9. So far you have. Okay, and remember this comes in right after the second beat, so it's 2 and 3 and 4. All right, then we're gonna have 8th fret of the B string, 10th fret of the B string. And then the first beat of the next measure is where F major comes in. And we're gonna play that 8th fret of the high E string. So that full measure starting from the end of the last lick would be like this. So we have 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1. All right, now we're ready to learn. Very cool phrase over F major. Okay, very good, everybody. Now we have enough licks to take us all the way through C major, all the way through D minor, and then drop us off to the four chord F major. Everything you have so far, a one, two, three, and four. Okay, now tackling the F major chord. Okay, the next lick is gonna take you from F to G, because remember, we only have one measure on both of those chords. It's gonna sound like this. A little bit slower. Nice kind of melodic line to go between those two chords. All right, so 8th fret of the high E string, that's where we left off before. 10th fret B, and then we're gonna play 10-10, B and G. So far you have. Now, 8th on the B, twice, one short, one long, before going back to 10 on the B string. Now, here's your transition going from F to G. 10-10-8. G, B, high E string. I love this phrase. And then right here, we're going down to 7 for the G major chord. Now this note is also important because it's right inside the D shape of the G chord. Okay, so if I take a D chord, play it on the 7th fret, I'm playing G major. Okay, and that's why that note is gonna sound so good over top of that G chord. Okay, so that full measure going from F to G. All right, now with the count, a one and two and a three and four, E and a one, E and a one. Some 16th notes there. Okay, now jumping into the G chord. Okay, very good, everybody. Now we're moving on to the final two licks. We just came out of the F major chord. Now, over the G major chord, we're gonna play this really smooth phrase. Sounds like this. Utilizing that E position of the C major pentatonic scale. Okay, so how do we do that? So we just got dropped off on the 7th fret of the high E string. Okay, right after the second beat, we're going to play a little staircase shape. 9-8-7. We're gonna give that a sweep strum with some muted strings. And then play the 10th fret of the high E string. Then follow that up by sliding up to the 7th fret of the high E string. Once you've made it there, we're gonna do an arpeggio of that little D shape that we had before. Also, it's also a part of that C shape of the G chord that we talked about earlier when we were discussing the progression. Okay, so. So that was 7, 8, 7, 10, and then sliding from 8 up to 9 on the D string. Very, very cool bluesy, kind of jazzy phrase you can play over top of this 5 chord. Okay, so. Once you've made it there, I might do a double slide there, kind of optional. And then end it, okay? So to end this phrase, we're gonna go down to 7, 10 on the A, 7 on the A, and then go to 10 on the D. That's another root note for the C chord, so the C chord has just arrived. Okay, that full lick over G major. Okay, and then from there, we're just gonna have some double stops descending down the neck to get you to the C7 chord, which starts everything back over again. Your final lick is gonna sound like this. Okay, so That's going to be 9 and 8 on the G and B strings. Bring it down a whole step. All right, then we're gonna play these two notes twice and get us to 5 and 5. So. Then, here's a way of going from C major to C7. Finding those two notes that are inside of the C7 chord. So that was the 5th fret of the B string and the 3rd fret of the G string. Watch where we're descending the G string. 5, 4, 3. Okay, to finish up this solo. Okay, let's play everything that we have, taking you through the entire progression now. It's gonna sound like this. A 1, 2, 3, and 4, and a C. See, it was the chord progression that dictated which notes I played, inspiring the licks all the way throughout that progression. All right, everyone, practice those licks nice and slow. Get them down into your muscle memory. Now I'm going to play the backing track for you a few times through, so that way you can practice each of these licks and be able to put together this entire solo. All right, friends, thanks so much for checking out this lead guitar tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks so much to my patrons for making all these lessons possible. I hope you're enjoying the extra resources. Thanks to you guys, I got many more videos coming up, so keep checking back. Please subscribe, please share. This is Rob at Swift Guitar Lessons in Philadelphia, saying happy picking.